All right, welcome back, everyone. We are in forever skies, although it is fitting that it is raining because we are going to learn about piping today. So I'm going to put timestamps below because I'm going to do a showcase of what I have built right up there. And then I built this little jig over here so we can create our own right here, live on this video. Live for me, not live for you. And hopefully by the end of this, you will understand how to do piping. It is not like, oh, this is how you do everything to do with the gardening update. I'm not going to go in and plant things and all that stuff, but this is going to show you all the piping stuff. So first, let's take a look at what I did up there. So in here, I just have some largers with no piping. And then I have this giant mess, all this stuff, and it all works. You can see. I've even piped it straight into my purifier. Very cool. Hey, the sun came out. Good timing for the sun to come out. I said off. I guess off doesn't mean off to him. But you can see, I've got this doubled. It goes on both sides. I have nice junctions, not perfectly 90 degree angles, but pretty darn close. I've got it running along the edge. It was a reason because I had to get around this. Going around this so I didn't have it just all one solid line, it was a real pain in the butt. And getting three of them on one table is a nightmare. They really need to work on the collision on these things. It's all messed up. But yeah, you can see lots of work on getting these angles right, getting the pipes right against the wall. You got double inlets over here. So we got double condensers. The condensers feed in through a connector. Connector goes into the pipes. Again, not perfect, but I had to be able to have a little space between there to be able to get in and actually do that. And yeah, it was, yeah, it was fun. And then also what I did with the fuel addition, and you can see this was real interesting. So you've got your fuel tank and it's got double outlets, right? So making that a nice straight line, getting those things set up. Come over here. It's kind of weird how it doesn't show the connection there, but it does work. And it goes to the engines on both sides. Pretty cool. And I have this on both. You can see it's on both sides. So this is a quad engine ship for max speed. Spud. Alright, so what are some of the things you're going to need? So in the gardening update, we have these things, obviously. But we also have a lot of this stuff. So you're going to get this, and this just by proxy of the gardening update. Then you have to find things like the tank and the... I think you have to find the generator, but don't quote me on that. The sprinklers, that kind of stuff. Then to make the bigger sprinklers, you bring a smaller sprinkler over here. Make a bigger one, a bigger water tank, etc. And then you go out and you have fun placing all kinds of stuff and screaming at your screen because it's being a pain. And yeah, so now we have this nice little space here and we want to make a greenhouse out of it. We have our water collection already placed. I don't have the condenser in it because I want to show this empty first and turn it on and show that it works. So the best way I've found, so I'm going to put my tank inside here because... if you place your tank outside, and I'll show you what happens. So I got my tank here, right? At the bottom you have your inlets, and at the top you have your exits. You can see the arrows on it. The arrow is pointing the direction the water is going to flow. Here's the problem. If I take a pipe here, I can't connect to it. And the reason I can't connect to it is you look at the radiant lines coming off of the pipe. There's no ceiling out here. It's just air. it needs a ceiling. Now here it's because there's literally no physical thing to connect to, but I can't even force connect it. Like, hello, it won't go in at all because there's no ceiling out here. So that doesn't mean you can never put anything out here. It just means you need to do some shenanigans. That's not for this video. It's for a different video. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to take a pipe, or not the cross pipe, excuse me, pipe socket. We're going to come inside and we're going to see, because I like nice straight lines. I got a little bit of OCD going on. I like nice straight lines. So in this, you're going to have, I guess I should show you the pipe so you understand the flow of this. So you have two ends of this pipe. You have this tennis ball looking thing on the left where my pointer is, and then you have the open bit, so the closed and the open bit of the deal. So if I click here, it works. But if I turn this like this, it doesn't connect because the tennis ball looking dude needs to go into the four triangles. So tennis ball into four triangles, and that is pushing the water this direction. That means on this end, I need to have a tennis ball because the tennis ball is always going to be from this way. It's always going to be on your left going this way for the way that's set up right there. So that means I grab my socket, and by default, the tennis ball is facing me. I need to flip it using R. Now the tennis ball is facing outside. Now I want to get this pretty straight. I got to find my line. Looks like it's about right there. And I got to go pretty low on this, about right there. Seems all right. So now I'm going to grab a pipe and I'm going to connect that. Hoppity doo-dah, and bam. It's a little off. It's connected, but it's a little, I'm going to change that. That's going to bother me to no end. Just the look of it's going to bother me. All right, let's go in here and see how. All right, so I got to be lower. That's fine. And this is kind of the, not really problem, because you don't have to go to this length. I do because it drives me crazy. So I want to come just right there. So it's just above the floor, and that should give me the closest point on this to give a straight line, but also connected. Well, it's better. So now inside here, the way you want to determine this, you grab your guy, right? And you have the inlets are facing me right now, and the exits, you can't really see because I can't, you can see it up there. There you are. You can just barely see them at the top. So if I want this to be as far over as I can, I just snap right there like that. It does not always work. I can tell you as fact, it will not always snap. Sometimes it does. It has something to do with the collision of where you place that and where it actually ends up being. But that worked. I'm going to leave it. It means I don't have to do anything else with it, although it's a little off kilter, and that's going to bug me. Whatever. We're just going to deal with it. So now you have two options. You have this. Again, the arrows are pointing that direction, so they're pointing towards sprinklers. On this side, I'm going to do small sprinklers, so it just says the word sprinkler. Now, the two options you have, if you look at this, the tennis ball is facing me, and the other ends, the open end is facing that direction. Again, you can see the triangle is pointing the direction it's going to flow. So I can either straight connect, just like that, which honestly would work fine for me. The placement's okay. Or you can take it and let's get this and let's do a nice little straight line. I'm just going to do the minimum distance. I just want to do a proof of concept of what you're doing here and not go all the way into detail. So now, you know what? I'm going to turn snapping on. That way it's straight lines. There we go. So now, We've got this connected, this connected. You see the green light is on. That means these are connected to the water. It's connected to at least a tank. Doesn't have to be connected to a water collection because you can fill the tank manually. Maybe. Yeah, add dirty water. So now we have two sprinklers here, and if it were me, I would place larges. Place some large gardens. I would place larges under here. So we got this. Let's go. This is the hard part, because there is no easy way to determine where this water is going to come down. So, like, I'm too far forward right there. And this is something FFH definitely needs to change. Still too far forward. That should be good there. And left, right. Left, right will be good enough. So that large plant will get up almost all the way to the height of that. Larges you don't really want to put on tables. You can, but boy, they're going to become a problem if you put them on a table. So now I have an extra outlet right there, and I have some bigger sprinklers. So let's see what we can do with that. So we're going to come from there. We're going to come all the way out as far as this will go. Try to get a decently straight line. That looks good to me. All right, so now let's see how big my large is. So if I snap it there, it's not quite where I would like it to be. Do I have enough room to get? I probably have enough room to get there. So let's place another small piece. This is just going to be the minimum distance. So we're not going to extend this in any way. We're just going to leave it as is, like that. So now we got an extra little piece, like a little extension cord, so to speak. And we're going to take this and we're going to plop that in there like that. So now we can place a nice big table right here and put some small ones on it. And now we have an exit over here. So we are going to, I don't know what I'm doing apparently. We're going to grab this and pop this exit. And we're going to come just about. Now, did you notice it's wanting to go down? So if I do like this, I need to actually get it fairly close to this ceiling, and I'll show you why in a minute. Right there. This is the tricky part, and this is what a lot of people have issues with, and this is what is a real pain. So right now it's defaulting to this because, and I'll show you why this is doing this. This snap point is too close to this wall. So it's defaulting to the wall instead of defaulting to the ceiling because it's too close. So what I need to do is I need to shrink this just a little bit. So instead of going out the full length on that one, so right there's the full length. I'm going to come back a little bit. About like that. We're going to add just the minimum. Right there. So now, we are going to add our large back in. There it is. Now, it's far enough away from the wall that it should default to ceiling this time. It did. So now what we want to do is I want to get this. We're going to do a nice little straight line because I'm going to do a different method over here. And before I do that nice extra straight line, we're going to grab another one. I want a second one over here. But I have to do it this way. And the reason I have to do it this way is because of the flow of the water. So if I want to bring this and I want to say I want it pretty close, not all the way at the very edge, about like that. So that means I need to get that ball clear to there. So we're going to grab this pipe here. Pop that in. I don't like that. Now, yes, you can do this and that's fine. That bothers me. My OCD's like, no, no, fam. Go about like that. Now, we are going to remove this out of our bag. We're going to grab this thing again, turn it, and just snap it right in place. So now we have a pretty reasonable straight line. We got this guy in. And now I want to do something a little different. I want to place another tank, right? I want to place a tank, and I want to place it on the ground. But I need to get from the ceiling to the wall as a transition. This is the part a lot of people struggle with. And we're going to show you how to fix this. So we're going to go like this. And what I'm going to do is I want this, and it's actually not allowing me to go any further. That means it is snapped to the wall at this point. When I connect this, it's already immediately on the wall. So let me do this again. Pick this up. Because I have this to where it's touching the wall. Like, I go out and I can't actually extend it any further. I'm immediately on the wall. I have made that transition as a 90 degree because I pushed it up against. Now, it doesn't obviously doesn't work with the device itself. Well, it did. It actually did cause the 90. But it doesn't work the way we want it to. So for this, we're going to do a little short pipe. Come on now. Let's get this thing nice and straight. Bam. And then we're going to go down. And we know from experience how low those things are. So we're going to go try to get this as straight a vertical line as I can. About like that. Now let's grab this thing back up. Now, I don't know why you would be putting a water tank on the ground, but we are for the sake of this. So you see it snapped? See it jumping by itself? Boom. This tank is connected now, and I could run to, I don't know, whatever other tanks if I chose to. So now we got place we can that looks right there. I need to go back just a little bit. Remember our position. About like that. Pretty good. Let's grab a little jobby here. Turn snapping off so I can. And there you go. Did I build a second tank? I did not. Now, very last thing. Oh, right. Just come in here and add it. Add it. That's going to start filling up. That's going to start filling that. That's going to turn these guys on. I'm going to turn them off. While it's filling, you can hear it now. Ah, did you see the pipe change color? Because if I don't turn these off, they're going to go nuts. And they're just going to start spraying water everywhere. So as this goes, see, pipes change color. And this thing's going to start filling. It takes a while because this thing holds a lot. It's more than 20. Hey, 38 or 40 or something. Holds a lot. Alright, I'm going to add some water just to get this to speed up. Alright, so I added a little bit of water. And now, so I have this turned off, and if I turn this on over here, it's raining. Okay, turn that back off. Now if I want, you notice how that's filling too? See that? There's water in it. The whole chain works even if your sprinklers are off. So, remember, I have one here. Let's turn this one on. It's now raining over that one. We can turn that back off. So they all work independently of each other. The chain works independently of these being on or off. And you can snap direct if you choose to, if that fits your model. I tend to like things being closer to the edge of the wall. But for demonstration purposes, this works fine. This allows you a way to do, I don't know, some extra kind of decoration in your place. I don't know. But you get the idea. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.